goes till I get up. Time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us, and love is all we'll ever trust. Yeah, no, I don't wanna waste what's left.
So hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be on this look right here. So I asked some friends what they want to see, and they said they want to see a summer look. So this is the look that I came up with. It is a more like summer glam look, because I tend to do more glam type stuff, and I know a lot of people like that's what I do. So I wanted to do like the summer look that I like to do, which is be this like little glam look. If you want to see one that's more toned down, I can definitely do that, more like a real summer look and not so much of a summer glam look. So if you want to see that, you can comment that down below and I can do that. So if you like this look and you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. That sure means a lot to me and it really helps my channel out. Also, while you're at it, if you don't mind subscribing to my channel if you haven't already, and go ahead and hit that little post notification bell down below, the one that looks like a little Taco Bell bell. That way you don't miss out on a thing. You can see whenever I post and you just don't miss anything really. Anyways, I'm really bad about rambling, so if you want to see how I created this look, keep watching because I'm going to show you now. So first I'm going to take this Urban Decay Primer Potion in Eden, and I'm just going to apply it to my eye. Normally I set this with powder, but I'm just going to tap it in instead of setting it with powder. First I'm going to pick up this shade right here from the Subculture palette from Anastasia Beverly Hills, and that is the color Edge. Gonna pick it up on the little brush that it comes with, and the little like more packed in. I'm just gonna pick it up and just kind of lay it in here, kind of sloppily, nothing too precise. Then I'm just gonna take a Morphe M433 and blend that out. And before I forget, I'm going to take this Anastasia Beverly Hills Rizzy highlighter, and I'm going to apply it to my brow bone. And I'm just going to take a Morphe M4213 and just hit the brow bone with it a little bit. You don't have to do this before. I prefer to, because for me, if it's too much, the blending blends it down. Alright, and then I'm just going to pick up that Edge color again, place it down, and blend it out just again. It doesn't have to be perfect when you place it down, because you're just setting it down. Alright, now I'm going to that same Anastasia Beverly Hills palette. I'm just going to pick up this color New Wave, which is a darker, bright yellowy color. And I'm just going to do pretty much the same thing. And then I'm just going to take the other end of that blending brush that came in the palette and blend it out. I'm going to go in with the color Fudge from the Anastasia Subculture palette. I'm just going to take it on this little brush from BH Cosmetics, just like a little flat brush. And I'm just going to place it in the inner corner, a little bit in the outer, and just so slightly take the leftover and kind of round it out. And doesn't have to be perfect. I'm going to take this Morphe E1A and I'm just going to blend that out. just gonna go in with that new wave, just to kind of blend it a little bit easier, or blend out the harshness. I'm just gonna take some of that primer impression again and just kind of go down the center a bit. I'm now going to take this Tarte Chrome Pink Pot. You can't really see it on camera because of my lights, but I'm taking it in a Top Yacht and I'm just going to apply that to the center. So now that I've done that, I'm going to go back into the color Edge and I'm just going to apply it on the sides before I just apply that color. Just for some pop of color and some blending. Now I'm going to go back in with Fudge on the inner corners because I lost some of it in the outer corner. I'm going to take this little small liner brush and go in with Fudge and just ever so lightly around the tip. And then I'm just gonna so slightly go over right here. I feel like it's a little harsh. And this is just whatever leftover product is on these two layers. So you could leave this here like this if this is what you like. But I'm going to go into the Urban Decay Heavy Metal Glitter Liner and Midnight Cowboy just to spice it up some. Now I'm just gonna take that brush and use the yellow from the corner. Use the kind of dust away. I feel like it's too much. I'm going to stop right here for the top eye. Besides doing mascara and lashes and whatnot, if you want to add eyeliner, you're more than welcome to. Me personally, I've been going without eyeliner lately, so I'm just going to skip on that. And I'm just going to clean it up a little bit with a baby wipe, clean up the fallout that I need. So I'm going to go into the rest of the look. I'm going to do lashes and all that at the end and touch up my brows at the end. I don't like to put mascara on until I've like set my face because otherwise it can kind of transfer a little bit, so I'm going to save that to do last. Alright, to promise again, I'm going to go into the Hangover primer. I used to have the full size of this and I used it all. It's really good primer for summertime and for like really dry skin. I have oily skin, but I really do still like this. I just haven't really gotten around to repurchasing it because I just try a bunch of new stuff and I don't know, it's such a good primer though. So next I'm going to go into the Huda Beauty Faux Filter Foundation. I was going to save this to do like a wear test, in which I still can, but sometimes I know people don't like to wear a whole lot of makeup, but for me, I'm a full coverage person no matter what the day, the year, the time of the year, whatever. I'm full coverage always. And as you can see, I'm having a little breakout right now. Don't know what's going on, but we're gonna see if this is actually as full coverage as it says. I'm gonna use a beauty blender, which I know that won't make it as full coverage, but I'm gonna do it anyway because I don't like brushes. So, that was that. So I'm just going to apply pump on the top of something. I'm just going to do two pumps, that should be good for me. And I'm just going to apply it to my face. It has a really floral scent, and I wasn't really expecting this to have too much of a smell to it. A lot of people I know that wouldn't bother. It doesn't really bother me, or it might bother people, actually. It doesn't bother me, but I know it could bother other people. But I'm just gonna start on the lower half of my face like I normally do. And now I'm just gonna go in with my beauty blender and melt it. I don't wanna waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us, and love is all we'll ever try. So next I'm gonna go in with my Tarte Shape Tape and just highlight like I normally would, and I'm really worried this isn't going to be I've been really into cream contouring lately, so I'm gonna take this Makeup Revolution concealer and I'm just going to very lightly use it because a little bit of this goes a long way. I can already tell I used too much. I know it looks crazy, but I'm gonna go back into that Tarte Shape Tape and fix this up. Alright, now I'm just gonna blend this all out to clean everything up. Yeah, that looks so much better already. Alright, so I'm gonna go on my Maybelline Fit Me powder in there, and I'm just going to set my under eyes and my T-zone. And when I do this, I'll use a powder. I'm gonna spray everything later. So if you have like dry skin, I probably wouldn't recommend like baking like I'm gonna do in just a few minutes. But if you don't and you have oily skin like me, it's perfect. You probably could continue doing this. Even for summertime, it doesn't bother for me to use all these powders because like I get super oily, so this can like keep me from getting like super greasy and oily looking. Now I'm gonna go in with my Coty Ear Spot and set the rest of my face. Alright, I'm gonna wipe everything off. Now I'm gonna go into my Benefit Blush Bar and I'm just going to go into the Hoola Bronzer. This right here, and I'm going to make my face look not so flat. Time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left. Now I'm gonna take this little small BH brush and chisel off my nose. Some. Now I'm gonna carve out everything, going back in with my Maybelline Fit Me powder. I'm going to bake now. I'm gonna let this sit for a few minutes and I'll come back, we'll finish off the rest of my face, finish up my eyes, all that jazz. So I'm just going to dust all this powder on. So now I'm going to go back into the Anastasia Beverly Hills On Lacy Highlighter. I'm going to highlight my face. Swap to this little smaller brush and just go ahead to go down my nose a little bit on the bridge. Then just going to do a little bit on the bridge. Just a slide as well as I could here. And then out. And on the Cupid's bow as well. In the inner corners of my eyes. Now I'm going to take this Milani blush in Luminoso and just apply some. Now I'm just going to take this Gerard Cosmetics Slay All Day Setting Spray in Coconut. This is seriously my favorite setting spray. Let it dry a little bit. And before it completely dries, I'm just going to hit those high points one more time. Just to make sure this really pops. Now I'm going to take this TARDIS lip paint in the color and the shade Low Key and apply it to my lips. And then I'm going to go to my eyes, of course, afterwards. Alright, first things first, I'm going to go into this NYX Wonder Pencil and line my waterline. Wow, what was that? So hard to think. So first I'm going to go into the first yellow color edge that I had started on the cloth with. And just using that stiffer side on that palette. And go back in with it again. With the Morphe M433 and blend that out fine. I'm just going to go in with that second bright yellow color and kind of do the same. I'm going to go in with fudge and kind of do. Now I'm just going to add some of the Benefit Bad Gal Dang mascara. So I'm not going to apply mascara to the bottom lashes because my lashes are too long and they will go everywhere. So you could stop here if you want, but I'm going to, of course, go beyond. And I'm going to apply some Lily lashes. These are the Sephora Lily lashes, which are the same exact thing, but these are in Mykonos. So I really hope you enjoyed this video. I had a lot of fun creating this look. It was so, so much fun. I'm so excited how it turned out. So yeah, I did like new lighting. This backdrop I did use last time, but I have new lighting, a new camera. So I really hope that this video turns out so much better than the rest of my videos, and I really hope that you all enjoyed it. I'm working really hard trying to make sure that I can really into my channel. I know I've really been slacking off, but I really want to put my all into it and continue putting out stuff for people, because I really like to show people how I do my makeup. It gets asked a lot, and I really like to show it because I like to teach it. So yeah, I know I said it in the beginning, but if you aren't subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and do that. I would really, really, really appreciate it. Would love for you to be here. Love for you to keep up with everything I do. So anyways, yeah, that's it for this video. Hope you all enjoy it, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.